Okay, meron akong makikita na naka-turn on yung camera. Okay, nakikita ba yung screen ko?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, here's the thing, no? First bago ako mag-discuss, I want you to type whether you already watch the first module. So, paki-type yung yes for those students who already watch the first module. Okay, on the message box on our Google Meet, I want you to type yes for those students who already watched the first module. Di ba meron akong recorded wherein that recorded corresponds to the first discussion that I have for this subject. So today, I will be discussing the module 2, no? Module 2 yung i-discuss natin. Opya, yeah. Nawala. Okay, so just a few reminders, no? Hindi pa ako nakapag-upload ng examination natin, the short quiz, hindi ko pa siya in-upload. Kasabay na lang siya nung quiz natin for Module 2, no? Ibig sabihin, I'll be uploading that, pero magkahiwalay sila, pero sabay silang i-upload later on. So, maybe next week ma-upload sila. Now, I just want to ask, do you have any scheduled subject every Tuesday? Kasi yung parang consultation natin is every Tuesday. Do you have any subject every Tuesday? 5 onwards. Meron ba?
Wala po, sir.
How about the others? Block section ba to? Block section ba kayo? Kasi para kasing ang nangyayari is parang medyo ano eh, bitin yung ano, if Thursday ako magdi-discuss tapos every Tuesday ma-upload yung quiz natin. So, starting next week kasi, we will be changing our schedule into Tuesday yung broadcast, then Thursday yung quiz. Okay? So, amenable ba tayo dun lahat? Is it okay sa atin? Kasi para hindi masyadong, you know, putol, no? Paki-type okay for those students who doesn't have subject and conflict for that particular Tuesday. And then Thursday yung magiging ano natin, uploading ng quiz. Okay, so I see okay. Okay. But then I'll see to it na meron namang announcement din doon sa team natin so that other classmates would have view it, no? Okay, so I think generally lahat naman, no? Lahat naman amenable in moving our class. The same time pa rin naman 'yon. Instead na Tuesday ang consultation natin, magiging Thursday siya. And instead na Thursday yung live class natin, magiging Tuesday lang siya. Same lang naman, nagpalit lang sila ng type nung ano. Okay?
Sir.
So, yes.
Sir, may klase po kami ng kay PE. 6 to 9 po yung Tuesday namin sa kanya.
Ah, meron kayong klase.
Yes, sir.
Live 'yon, broadcast 'yon.
Yes.
Broadcast siya.
Yes po, PE po sir.
Lahat kayo?
Opo.
Ah, I see. So hindi rin siya possible, no? Okay. So if hindi siya possible, anyway, mag-i-stick tayo sa schedule natin as scheduled, no? Okay. So sige, sige. Anyway, okay lang if may conflict, sige, we'll stick to ano, to the bitin schedule. Okay? So okay lang if not possible. Anyway, let's proceed with expect that on Tuesday dalawang quiz yung medyo ma-upload dun sa MS Teams natin. Okay? Now, if you have any questions, clarification, just message me on my MS Teams. I'll be answering all of that once na nakita ko yung message niya. Okay? Our topic number two is freedom of speech. Okay? So, this is already uploaded in our MS Teams. The document file and then the PowerPoint presentation is already available in module 2. Okay? So, this is our topic, freedom of speech. Okay? Okay? So, this is our objective for today. So to recognize freedom of speech, what are the issues raised about freedom of speech? No, we analyze the freedom of speech. Kasi kapag once na we have the word freedom of speech, we always see to it na parang it's democracy. No, lalo na ngayon, medyo laging na nakikita yan, lalo na we are nearing in election, no? Now, again, yung subject kasi natin is medyo broad siya, medyo diverse siya, medyo general siya. So, most of the time, hindi naman siya applied talaga in computer, no? Hindi siya applied in computer. Maybe this is just applied on a law, no? With a glimpse of computer, pero typically hindi talaga siya ganun ka-focus, no? For this topic, no. Makikita natin dito we have the Friend Republic Act, no, article numbers, no. Okay? So yan yung mga yan. Now let's start with changing communication paradigm, no. So regulating communications media. So in the Philippines, no, in the Philippines we have different communication media. Ano-ano yung mga different communication media natin? Kapag sinabi natin communication media, these are the different mediums wherein we try to communicate with others. Let's say, for example, no, meron tayong print media. Example niyan are newspapers, magazines, books. No? Ito yung ginagamit ng mga tao to inform, okay? To give information. Okay? Meron din tayong broadcast. Okay? Wherein, ang example na ito are television and radio. Meron tayong makikitang news program, meron tayong radio programs that inform, no? And then meron din tayong common carries like telephone, postal system, na yung mga yan, no? Kapag sinabi natin common carries, ito yung mga parang communication lines, no? Postal system, ito yung mga snail mail, yung mga sulat, no? Okay, telephones, yan yung mga broadcast wherein parang group messages, di ba, yung mga ganyan. Okay, these are the different communication medias. Okay? Now, meron tayong tinatawag na parang Telecommunication Act of 1996. So, di ba, batas agad to. No, pero hindi, again, no, let me remind everyone na hindi natin kailangan sauluhin itong mga ito. Okay, hindi natin kailangan sauluhin itong mga to. Okay? All we have to do is to just be familiarized with them. Okay? Now, in Act of 1996, change regulatory structure and remove artificial legal divisions of services areas and restriction on services that telephone companies can provide. Further, no provider or users of interactive computer service shall be treated as a publisher of any information provided by other information content provider. So anong ibig sabihin nun? Okay, anong ibig sabihin na itong Republic Act of 1996? It says that yung regulation ng telecommunication before, way back 1996, is in provision kung ano yung gusto ng company. Ano ba? Now, can you give me example of different telecommunication company? Pakitype. Okay, I want participation here. Okay, pakitype yung mga examples natin ng different telecommunication companies. Let me remind everyone na itong ginagawa natin are recorded. No? Ibig sabihin, I could go back with the logs kung sino yung mga nag-participate in the recitation. No? Itong recitation natin, ito siya, yung nandito sa message board natin. Okay? So, continue. Let's continue. Ito rin, no? Republic Act din. Okay? So, 1994 naman, meron pang pumapasok. Accept ko lang. Okay. Yung 1994 naman, to promote and govern the development of Philippine telecommunication and delivery of the public communication services. Okay. Kasi parang, in a way, no? In a way, connected siya in IT, pero these are means of telecommunication, eh, no? Okay. So, it's like, isa-summarize lang natin, no? Isa-summarize natin. It's like, the Philippine telecommunication should deliver, okay, public services. Okay, like yan, yung mga example ng mga yan, yung mga TNT, Globe, Smart, no? Okay, ano yung bago ngayon? Meron tayong Dito, no? Okay, pero telecommunication company are not just those, no? Mga internet providers, they are also considered as telecommunication companies. Okay? Okay. So baka matakot kayo yung mga quiz nyo maging ganito, no? Hindi, no? Hindi magiging ganyan. Okay? Kasi puro mga batas-batas to. So halimbawa, hindi nyo kailangan sauluhin yung mga Republic Act number 7925, no? Kasi I myself hindi ako familiarized sa kanila. Pero if I saw them, medyo alam ko lang sila explain. Okay? Now, what are the free speech principles? Okay, so in here we have written for offensive and or controversial speech and idea. Okay, restriction on the power of government, not individuals or private business. Okay, so written for offensive and or controversial speech and idea. So free speech principles are like this. So it's like you could write any offensive or controversial speech and ideas. Okay? Also, no, there would no restriction on the power on the side of the government or in the individual. Ibig sabihin, kahit ano pwede mong isulat. Kahit ano pwede mong sabihin. That's a free speech principle. Okay? So ganun siya. Again, topic kasi natin dito, free speech. Eh, no? Okay. Now, meron din namang sinusunod, yun na, for individual yun. No? So, meron din namang sinusunod yung Supreme Court with regards of principles and guidelines. No? So, advocating illegal act is illegal. So, pagpo-promote ng mga illegal act is illegal. So, pwede ka makasuhan doon. Okay? Does not protect libel and direct specific threat. So, hindi rin kahit na nasa free speech tayo, halimbawa, minura mo yung isang tao, siniraan mo siya, okay? In your way kasi, free speech yun. Pwede kang kasuhan kasi that's an act of libel and assault, okay? Also, inciting violence is illegal. Pag sinabi natin inciting, ibig sabihin, pwedeng mag-ano ka, yung parang mag-utos, okay? Sutukin mo nga yan, yung mga ganun, no? Okay? So, allow some restriction on advertising. So, hindi lahat pwede mong i-advertise. Hindi lahat pwede mong ilabas. You have the freedom to speech, pero to speak, pero hindi lahat yon pwede mong i-broadcast. Okay? So, you should also protect some anonymous speeches. Okay? So, medyo, you know, parang yung mga idea dito talaga magsasama-sama. Eh. Okay? So, next is everyone has the right to freedom of opinion and expression. Okay? So, this right includes the right to hold opinion without interference, to seek and receive impart information and ideas through any media and regardless of frontiers. So, ito yung ano, based from a democratic country. No? This was produced December 1948. No? Under human rights Okay? So, anyone do have a freedom of speech regardless. Okay? So, pwede. Lahat yan. Kaya nga sinasabi nila, every opinion is correct. Okay? So, if you're familiar with that. Okay? Diyan yan. So, under naman, Section 4, under Constitution 1987, so no law shall be passed abridging the freedom of speech or of expression or of the press or the right of the people peaceably to assemble and petition the government for a redress of grievances. So, ibig sabihin, okay, wala namang naipapasang batas, okay, regarding in freedom of speech or expression for the press or for the press. Pag sinabi natin for the press, ito yung sa media. Okay? Ito yung sa media. Okay? So, basta halimbawa, kapag sinabi natin peaceably, ibig sabihin, as long as the freedom of speech corresponds to peace, okay, walang kaso yan. Okay? So, that is a Bill of Rights. Okay, Bill of Rights yan. Okay? Now, controlling offensive speech. Okay? What is it? What is illegal? So, ano-ano nga ba yung offensive speech? Kasi, di ba, freedom of speech. Now, we have a good speech, we have offensive speech. Ano-ano yung mga yon? Okay? So, the answer depends on who you are. Okay? Many efforts to censor the internet with a focus on child pornography or sexual explicit material. Okay? So, as you can see in here, no, medyo makikita na natin what is offensive, no? It's not, kapag sinabi kasi natin offensive, it's not just pasigaw. Okay? It's not just pabalang, no? It could be what? It could be sexual implicit, no? It could be focus on harassment. Those are illegal. Okay? Now, eto, nabanggit ko na rin kanina, no? Okay? So, obscenity, eto, depicts a sexual act against state law. Okay? Ibig sabihin, no? Pag sinabi natin obscenity, eto yung mga offensive speech regarding obscene. Okay? That might relate to sexual act. Example, kagaya nga na sinabi doon kanina, depends who you are. No, halimbawa, no? Kayong magkatropa, magkaibigan, babae, lalaki, magkatropa yan. Okay? Dahil magkatropa sila, sinabihan niya, "Oy, ang sexy mo naman. You're so sexy today." It's okay. Huh? It depends who you are. So, it's okay. Kaibigan mo, sinabihan ka, okay yon. Pero, halimbawa, ikaw, naglalakad ka, hindi mo kakilala, tapos sinabihan ka ng, "Wow, sexy mo naman." What would be your act? Diba? So, again, no? Doon papasok yung sinatawag natin, depends who you are. Okay? And that could already be illegal. Yung gano'n, na, oh, yung sexy mo naman. Diba? Even ngayon, catcalling nga ngayon, eh. Halos kapag ka pinaswitan ka, okay, kinatcall ka, pwede mo na siyang ipahuli. Okay? So, yan, no? Okay? So, ito, example lang to ng case ng gano'n. No? Based to on Ressa and Rappler, no? Na nagkaroon ng ganyan. Okay? So, yan, masyado siyang mahaba if we're going to read this, no? Pero this case was happened June 15, 2020, okay? And the parang suspect or parang yung kino-complain is charged with cyber libel. Okay? Okay, so dahil na charge siya ng cyber libel, okay? Pwede siyang makulong. Okay, kayo din, be careful with that. Kung halimbawa, no? Ganun siya, no? Any possible na ibibigay mo dun sa ano, could be charged as cyber libel sa iyo. Kapag ka hindi nila nagustuhan, 'di ba? Sinabi mo ang taba-taba na ni ganito. Okay? Dati kasi hindi kinukonsider ng court 'yon, pero ngayon all of that could be considered. Okay? Okay. Yan, no? Fake news could also be considered a cyber libel, no? Spreading fake news is a crime. Okay? Okay? Now, okay, as your ano, as your while I am discussing, I want you to type any isang fake news na nakita nyo. Okay? Isang fake news, hindi mahaba ah, yung parang title lang ng fake news na nakita nyo on the over the internet, no? Kasi fake news is more of rampant in the internet, no? Usually, doon lang naman 'yan eh, no? Wala ka naman makikitang fake news sa ano eh, sa dyaryo, eh. Wala ka rin makikitang fake news sa broadcast, TV Patrol, sa GMA, mga ganon na 24 oras, yung mga ganon, wala kang makikita kasi they have researcher. Pero yan sa Facebook, napaka, no? Buntis daw si Hipon. Okay, mga, okay, Bongbong Marcos clone, no? Yung mga yan, no? So, MOA, okay? So, those are fake news. Okay? So, yung mga yan, can be considered as cyber libel. And merong mga ano yan, may mga what they call this punishment. Okay? So yan, no? So spreading them, ayan, pwede kayong mag-report dito sa mga to. Yan. Okay? Okay? So spreading fake news is a crime. Okay. Tatlo lang yung sumagot, ha? Ay, ilan ba? 1, 2, 3, 4. Apat lang yung sumagot, ha? Ah, tatlo lang. Okay. Ah, hindi pa pumapasok yung ibang. Okay. Okay. So, ayan, no? This is just, ano, if you have time, pwede nyong basahin to. Okay. Dahil sa ginawa niya, okay, sa pagpapakalat ng fake news, nakasuhan siya ng cyber libel, okay, and the found out na guilty, ito lang naman yung naging ano niya, naging penalty niya. Okay? So, imprisonment up to 6 months and 1 day, okay, as minimum, to 6 years of prison correctional as maximum. Biruin mo yon, no? Okay? Okay? 6 years, tapos sa Bureau of Correction ka mapupunta. It's like, kahanay mo yung mga drug lords and other, di ba? Yung mga matitinding gumawa ng crime just because you have a cyber, di ba? Yung mga ganyan. So, okay? Hindi lahat naman ng nilalabas ni Rappler fake news. Grabe ka naman, Jemil, no? Yung iba lang. Oh, may mga na ano sila. Pero, yon, no? Okay? I have once issue na parang nakita ko na nagalit nga si Duterte dyan. Okay? Okay. So yan, no? Okay. So internet censorship law and alternatives. So meron tayong tinatawag na Communication Decency Act or CDA, no? Okay? So ano ba 'to? Okay? So this is primarily in response to concerns about minors accessing to child pornography. To access to pornography via internet. Okay, kasi 'di ba? Okay? In the Philippines, wala masyadong restriction. Okay? Pero if you go like for example, when I was in UAE in Dubai, in Abu Dhabi, okay, yung mga ganyan, they are fully black kasi nasa Muslim country ka. Bawal. Okay, as in talagang bawal, wala kang ma-access ng mga ganyan. They have law. Now dito sa Pilipinas, meron tayong law na ganyan. Pero wala siyang implementation. Hindi naman siya na-implement. Okay? So, that's why, no, kahit mga bata, they can access porn sites. Okay? Okay, let's accept that. No? Okay? Next. Okay, so, the CDA found out, kaya nila pinupush through to is because the worst material threatening children was already illegal. That's correct. Kasi it's a foreign site, no? It did not use restrictive means of accomplishing the goal of protecting the children. They are exposed, no? Na-expose pa sila, okay, for that. Okay? Next. Meron din tayong tinatawag na Child Online Protection Act. So, these are for obscene on commercial websites, no? So, ganun din, parang ganun din, pero they are more focused on let's say for example, they are publishing child pornography, okay, something like that. So hindi nila inaano 'yon. Okay? Pwede kang mahuli. Okay? Sa ganon. Okay? Yan. So these are the different sanctions and bounds of the Online Privacy Protection Act for Children. Okay? Oh, hindi na natin 'to masyadong i-elaborate kasi we're not law student naman. Okay? So I just want you to have an idea for this. Okay? Okay, meron tayong okay na tayo dito. Meron tayong Children's Internet Protection Act. Okay? Okay, so this one requires schools and libraries that participate in federal programs to install filtering software. Okay, meron din tayong batas tungkol doon na kapag halimbawa isang school ka, no, if you have internet connection, you should have firewall in protecting your children over the internet, na hindi nila ma-access yung mga series of sites. Okay? Kasi ang pwedeng makasuhan doon is yung school. Okay? Now, meron tayong tinatawag na Internet Censorship Law and Alternative Filters. Yan, no? Ibig sabihin, ito yung pwede nating gawin in creating in parang to fight, no, to fight yung mga ganyang klase ng censorship in the internet. Okay? So block the sites, no? Parental control, may mga parental control na kasi yung mga browser natin. Pwede yan. Okay? Not possible to eliminate all errors. Okay? Alam natin kung ano-ano yung mga ibablock natin. So kasama yung mga yan. So those are ano, the countermeasures na pwede nating gawin. Okay? Now, spam, no? Okay? What's the problem? So usually described as unsolicited. Ano ba 'tong mga 'to? So spam, ito yung mga unsolicited mail na meron kayo. 'Di ba? In your email, minsan makakatanggap ka na lang ng mga hindi mo naman email pero nakaka-receive ka. Those are spams, okay? So sometimes spams are used to get information from you, no? So beware of that. Kung halimbawa hindi ka naman nag-email for that, no? Better do not open them, directly trash it. Something ganun, no? Okay? So meron din tayong anti-spam law, no? Okay. Okay, meron din tayong anti-spam law, no? Yung anti-spam law naman is kung sino man, no? Okay, yung mahuhuli mo na sender ng spam, they can be sanctioned. Pwede silang makulong. Okay, pwede silang ma-legalize, no? Okay? Okay? So why is least restrictive means important? Do you consider the internet an appropriate tool for your young children? Why or why not? So this questions could be described in your age or in your mga kapatid, yung mga sister, brother niyo na mas bata sa inyo. Kasi usually, di ba, yung mga gusto nila, mga YouTube, mga ganyan, are they safe on that? No, lahat ba ng nakikita nila sa TikTok are good? Lahat ba ng nakikita ng mga kapatid niyo is good? Okay, over the internet. So, yan, mga ganyan. Okay? So, censorship pa rin, no? Okay? Block everything in an attempt to block one thing. Okay? So, ban in one country, move to another. Okay? So, yan yung mga yan. Yung example ko kanina, no? Okay? So, global net yung ginagawa nila. So, global impact. Libawa, blinak natin dito sa Philippines, pwede na rin i-block sa ibang country, yung mga ganun. Okay? They could consider that. So, that is censorship on a global net. Okay? Pwede naman yun, actually. Si One Telecommunication Company, kapag ka-blinak niya yung IP nun, kahit na sinong nakasubscribe sa kanya, ganun kasi yung ginagawa ng ibang bansa. So yung IP nun, yung public IP nun, ibablock. Then kahit na anong gawing browse, lumipat ng browser kahit saan, wala na, hindi na ma-access yun. kasi dumadaan sila in server. Okay? Okay, censorship in other motion. So I already mentioned this, no? By the way, no, yung magiging quiz nyo dito laging essay. Okay, kasi look at this, no? Okay? Para hindi kayo magsasaulo. Pero pagka nagku-quiz kayo, pwede niyo buksan ito ha, pwede niyo buksan yung PowerPoint presentation niyo so that you could read something. Pero hindi kayo allowed mag-copy and paste, no? You use your own words. Okay. Excuse me. Okay? So next tayo. So ito yung mga possible questions in global net. Okay, what is the impact does the global net have on free speech? Yun lang ang nagiging sinasabi nila, are they free, no? Pero you know, restricting something is good, no? Does censorship in other countries have an impact on free speech in PH? Okay? How does free speech in free countries impact more restrictive countries? Kasi halimbawa, compare mo yung Philippines sa UAE, no? Sila kasi less restrictive sila. Or restrictive sila, I mean. Sa Philippines kasi they are free. So ano yung mas okay? So yun lang naman yung mga parang ano mo dyan, gauging mo, yung wini-weigh mo dyan. Okay? So meron tayong tinatawag na campaign laws and the internet. So meron mga tinatawag na BCRA. Okay? This prohibits corporation, unions, and other organization from paying for ads that shows candidates' name or face close to election. Ito, no? Ngayon to nangyayari, no? So parang meron tayong ganito, yung laban sa campaign, yung parang I don't know whether you heard it, yung tinatawag natin premature campaigning, no? Yung hindi pa panahon ng kampanya pero you know, nagka-campaign na sila, madami yan, halos lahat sila. Okay? So those are illegal, pero you know, Philippines is Philippines. So 'yon, no? Even campaign law and in the internet are sanctioned. Ibig sabihin niyan, kahit sa TV, sa dyaryo, sa internet, dapat hindi pwede. Unless it is a campaign period already. No? Pero dahil dyan, okay, hindi naman nasusunod ito, no? Kahit may law, wala rin naman. Kasi usually, yung mga naggawa nito, no? Nangangampanya na rin sila ngayon. Okay? Dahil, you know, they are politicians. Okay? Anonymity, no? Common sense and the internet. Okay? Services available to send anonymous email. So, yun lang. No? Meron tayong mga ganyan. Di ba, meron yan yung parang sesendan mo yung sarili mo ng email. No? Okay? Maybe sa mga movies nakikita niyo yan. Parang, you know, sesendan mo yung sarili mo na after ilang weeks tsaka mo siya, after a year, dun mo ma-receive yan. Yung anonymizer.com. Yung mga ganyan. No? So parang it's a common sense in the internet. It's like parang magsisend ka ngayon, tapos after 10 years, marireceive mo siya o kumusta ka na, alam mo ba na dati, ganyan-ganyan. No? Pero sa sarili mo siya, mag-ano. Or sa other person. No? Okay? Protected ka ba? Yung mga ganyan. Meron din kasing ano. Meron, dahil nga sa anonymous yon, no? Anonymous yon. Pagka na found out na merong kang violation in legal basis, no? Pwede kang makulong. Okay, meron din sanction. Okay, pwede kang makulong. Okay, halimbawa, pina-flood mo ng information yung isang tao. Okay? Nang hindi niya alam. So, pwede ka ring makulong. Okay? Yan. So, fears, no? You could inflict fears. Pwedeng matakot yung tao, no? Okay, it could hide crime or even protect criminals. Okay? So, yan, no? Yan. So, these are the references actually kung saan kinuha yung mga ano natin. Okay? Yung ginawa yung presentation natin. Okay? So, yan. So, actually, maiksi lang naman talaga yung module number 2 natin. Kaya nga, pag sabi ko sa inyo, pagsasabayin na lang natin yung quiz natin ng number 1 module tsaka number 2 module. Okay? So that ends our lecture for today. Do you have any question? Question?
Sir, yung about, wala about to press freedom. Isa lang po ba yun?
Ano, ano?
Isa press freedom, sir. Hmm. Isa lang po ba yun? Or parang tugma po ba? Connect?
Hindi ko masyadong naintindihan. Medyo malakas yung background mo. Paki-type yung question mo. Okay. For my last question, I want you to type your answer before ending, no? Okay? Okay. So, one sentence lang yung answer natin dito, ha? One sentence lang. So, do you consider the internet an appropriate tool for your for young children? Yes or no? Why? Yes or no? Okay, yes and why? No and why? So, yun lang. Ganun lang. Kahit Tagalog, no? Okay? That is your final, ano, isa lang po ba yung press freedom tsaka freedom of speech? Yung freedom of speech, ano yon? On top siya. Then press freedom is on category of freedom of speech. Press freedom, individual, ano, individual freedom of speech, press freedom, no, yung mga yan. So, category sila. Okay? Again, let me repeat, no? Yung final question natin, no? So, isang sentence lang to, ha? Isang sentence lang. Do you consider the internet an appropriate tool for young children? Like for example, yung mga kapatid nyo, yes or no? And why? Okay? Pag na-answer na natin yan, that's it, no? Pwede na mag-leave, okay? Tapos, I'll see you guys next meeting. Okay, yung mga naka-answer lang, ha? Pagka hindi pa nakapag-answer, are not allowed to leave. Sa mga naka-answer na, okay, bye-bye. Sa mga hindi pa, just type your answer.
Sir, pwedeng Tagalog o English talaga?
Tagalog, okay lang. Tagalog, okay lang. Huwag lang Kapampangan. Okay, again, once you drop your answer, no, pwede na mag-leave ng meeting natin and I'll see you guys next week. Yes, may nagre-raise ng hand.
Good day, sir. Thank you po.